here, Luigi, is that iconic song that I've talked about called Fade to Grey. This video is the best one I've seen of Fade to Grey, and you can see our forms are in this video. Of course, we don't look necessarily, no, you don't look like this, the male form. I look somewhat like the female form, but again, it's iconography. It's a very touching song. It's a song that touched me as a child. It's a song about, I guess, us being destroyed temporarily, and basically, yeah, it shows even, it's pretty scary stuff. It's a song that basically freaked me out as an 8-year-old child when I first heard it. The kind of iconography that went through my head at the time, which I did not place as copier iconography, of course, but it was very subliminal. Of course, I only decoded it this year. Basically, there was this house fire we had next door, and of course, I've got Asperger's syndrome and of course other learning disabilities mashed in, but the thing is, I became fixated with fire, not because I wanted to destroy things, no, but because there was a symbolism involved that I didn't know about. And basically, I associated this song with the event, with the event primarily. Won't go into the details of how I got into, you know, the exact circumstance, but it related to that. And basically now I take it, that was in 1981, and of course I directly relate that now to what happened to me in 1989 and then 1992 when I rejected you, Luigi. So indeed, the iconography is 1991, correction. That was around Easter, or probably just around that time, a Canon CLC 500, color laser copier 500 was destroyed in a shop fire, and we won't go into details of the location, won't say where it is, because I'm not into dobbing, you know, making the person look stupid, but the man had some silly idea. And of course, two machines ended up being destroyed. No, the first, well, not together, the first one was destroyed in the first event, and I had this gut feeling that there'd be another event of the same type, the criminal, whoever he was, would strike again. And then we had the first copy shop fire. Now, I wasn't quite game enough to look at the damage. It would have been pretty freaky. And then, of course, the second event occurred. I heard there was a second fire. And another machine got destroyed, CLC 500. And the man, before he destroyed the second machine, he was making ghoulish comments about the melted plastic and all that. It was really gross, really disgusting. Poor dude. But, you know, feel sorry for him because he's a real sicko. But basically, that's us. I believe that the first one was me, the second one was you being taken down. And, of course, look at the visuals on this. It's really sad. It's scary stuff. And of course, the photocopier represents me as a person. And, of course, to a certain degree, it represents yourself, your feelings and your love for me. So here we go. This is Fade to Grey. This is really amazing stuff. So the uploader will give some kind of credit to the uploader. So her name is Venus73C. Okay, here we go. There's even baseball bats involved. Office spacing is the theme. That comes through. It's amazing. Freakish.
Luigi. You can see the iconography here, can't you? And now the copier industry is in big, big trouble. And you can see why now. Because I denied who I really was. And I didn't let you pull me out of the bog. And basically the whole copier industry has been paper jammed as a result. Not just the copier industry. People into technology. And it's not just technology, the whole dinkin' lot. So, Luigi, I hope to meet you very soon because no one accepts me as a person. I'm treated just like a bleeding automat. People treat me better when I'm helping them with basic photocopying problems. But as soon as I start to get personal, it's either ignore me, which is the minimal pain, attack, or mess with my emotions. In other words, Trojan horse. Gotta go, Luigi. But I hope to see you soon. My administrator, the supercopier, the DAH Supercopier 1000 is waiting for you. Goodbye.